Hey, YouTube family, I'm Patty Jackson. I'm your auntie of pop culture. We got the scoop. We got curls. We start off with a hug because you never know who may need a hug. So come on. It's not cute not knowing, and now it's time to know. Our prayers are going out to Nick Cannon. I tell you, I was planning on talking about Nick Cannon today. Never thought I'd be talking about this. Nick Cannon revealed on his talk show today that he lost his youngest son. Nick Cannon, the father of 7 kids, this child was 5 months old. He had a baby by model Alyssa Scott. The baby, 5-month-old, named Zen. Nick Cannon says they noticed a problem with their son when the little boy was 2 months old and there was swelling in his head and they realized it was a brain tumor. Nick says that around Thanksgiving, the baby took a turn for the worse, and unfortunately, the young baby has died. Our prayer is going out to Nick Cannon. The Jussie Smollett trial each day gets juicier, and who knows what the jury is going to say. Yesterday, Jussie took the stand, and he says he was the victim of a hate crime. He says that the two brothers, one of the brothers he said he didn't like, but he said the other brother he had a relationship with, and he did drugs with this man. Jussie says they were trying to extort him for up to $2 million. Now, you know what the brothers are saying. They're saying that Jussie paid them money to beat him up and make it look like it was a crime so that Jussie could, you know, make the headline to get all of this publicity. But something went wrong, and it would probably went wrong when Jussie would not fully cooperate in the beginning. You got to think, this happened in 2019, and we're still dealing with this. And at the end of the week, we're going to find out if Jussie is guilty or not. Now, if he's found guilty, I don't think he's going to do jail time, but he'll get probation. He'll probably have to pay fines, but his career, unfortunately, is ruined. And this whole situation here doesn't help. I don't even know how he can resurrect his career because this publicity and everything is so bad, but just not a good time. Not a good time for Jussie. And by the end of the week, we're going to find out if he's guilty or not. Alicia Keys is back. She's got a double CD coming out at the end of the week entitled Keys, Poet, Love Amanda Gorman. She's got a new book entitled Call Us What We Carry. The poet and activist just released the book today. It would probably make a great stocking stuffer. Faith Evans. Faith is really in a bind. She done married this man, Stevie J. There ain't no prenup. If you got $2, what do I say? Get a prenup. He said she was cheating. He said he was filing for divorce. Then he changed his mind. But he is still looking for money. Why are you looking for money from your wife? Why are you doing this to your wife? Do you love Faith Evans? Faith said she wasn't giving him a dime. But how is she going to get out of this crazy situation? Because apparently, Stevie J just married her for her money. Swiss Beatz, he has laid down the gauntlet. Swiss Beatz, him and Timberland, they put together these versus battles. Some have been great. Some have been like, what is going on? Like last week with 3-6 Mafia and Bones Thugs and Harmony. When that fight broke out, it was like, what is going on? Swiss is tired. Swiss says he's tired of people being drunk. Who's he talking about? He's tired of people being late. Swiss says, in the future, when they do the verses, if an artist shows up late, they ain't getting paid. Did you know they was getting paid? I didn't know they were making money. And then he said that some artists want to overcharge them. And he's like, you ain't had a hit in 50 years and you want to charge us all this money? Swiss is tired. Now, he could be talking about Keisha Cole with being late, because she was very late. I remember that night. I remember being tired, saying, where is this girl? And I said, we can't be sitting up all night waiting for somebody to show up. I don't know who he could be talking about if he says that they're drunk. I don't know. Who do you think he's talking about when he says can't show up drunk? But Swiss says they're not going to get paid. Yesterday, I was telling you about Netflix is a joke, big comedy thing. My girl, Lunel, is also on that lineup. That includes Dave Chappelle, Chris Rock, Amy Schumer, Ellen DeGeneres, Jerry Seinfeld, a whole bunch. You talking about the big, big names. And this festival is taking place next year. Netflix is a joke. Lunel is part of the lineup. You know, one of the big, when you think of horror movies, you know the running joke is the first person that's killed is a black person. Well, there's a new horror movie coming out where everybody's black. So, who dying first? Tim Story, who brought us the Barbershop Stories, is putting a movie together entitled The Blackening. It's about a group of friends who decide to go away for a weekend to a cabin. But what they don't know is there's a killer in the cabin. Check out the lineup. Jermaine Fowler, he was just Eddie Murphy's son in Coming to America. Yvonne Orji, Molly from Insecure. Grace Byers, Boo Boo Kitty from Empire, and she's one of the stars of Harlem. You got Sinqua Walls, who played Don Cornelius in the Soul Train movies. I can't wait to see this because everybody black. So who's going to die first? But Tim Story is putting this together. Let's get ready for tonight. Tonight's a huge night. It's just a huge night. There's the People's Choice Awards. Kenan Thompson is hosting. It's on NBC. Oscar winner Halle Berry is getting a Lifetime Achievement Award. You've got Dwayne The Rock Johnson just getting the People's Choice Biggest Award ever. Over on ABC, you got Live in front of a studio audience. And boys, there's so much anticipation about this. Kerry Washington, the great TV legend Norman Lear, Jimmy Kimmel, Will Ferrell, they are the executive producers of this, where they take shows from the past and give it a new twist. Where they recreate them, I should say. They're doing Facts of Life, which is real popular on NBC in the 80s. You got Jennifer Aniston playing the role of Blair. She's kind of like the head girl. Then you've got Gabrielle Union playing the role made famous by our girl, Regina. Kim Fields, well, she played Regine. She played two, The Effects of Life. Okay, I'm getting it together. But Kim Fields made it famous. But Gabrielle Union is playing that role. Over on Different Strokes, another popular NBC show, you got Kevin Hart playing the role made famous by Gary Coleman, Arnold Jackson. This is going to be interesting because Gary Coleman was actually a teen when this show was on. Kevin is a full-grown man. I think he's like 42. They're just little. But he's playing that role. Damon Wayans is playing the role made famous by Todd Bridges, Willis Jackson, and you got actor John Lithgow playing the role made famous by the dad about a dad who adopts two black kids. Ooh, I think it's going to be just funny, funny, funny. I'm hearing that Jon Stewart from The Late Show, he's going to be making some kind of appearance somewhere in this show. Now, right after that, you got Abbott Elementary. I've been talking about this show. I'm so excited because it looks really funny and just reminded me of this classic TV shows. Abbott Elementary is about an elementary school in Philadelphia, my hometown, and it stars a Philadelphia native, Quinta Brunson. It also stars Cheryl Lee Ralph. She's married to Senator Vincent Hughes, Broadway star. Cheryl Lee Ralph, she keeps the gig. Tyler James Williams, I got the name right, the young man from Everybody Hates Chris. It looks so funny. It's coming on at 9:30 tonight. So I want to talk about it and see what you guys thought. But it just reminded me of just great comedy shows. And I think this is going to be a winner for 2022. Sidney Poitier, one of the greatest actors ever. His life story is coming to Broadway. When you think of Sidney Poitier, the movies, guess who's coming to dinner? In the heat of the night. To Sir with Love, Lilies of the Field. He's a director, performer, and actor. This man who came from humble beginnings in the Bahama Islands went on to be one of the greatest actors ever. Here's something I didn't know. I didn't know that he directed Stir Crazy that starred Richard Pryor. Then you had the Let's Do It Again movies with Denise Nichols and Bill Cosby. So he's had a very varied career. But his private life was really interesting. I wonder, will they delve into Diane Carroll? Because even though Diane Carroll was married to somebody, Sidney Poitier was married to somebody, they had a long-lasting affair for years. Now, I wonder, will they put the Diane Carroll in it? But it's coming to Broadway. Hugh Hefner. What happened at that Playboy Mansion back in 1953 when Hugh Hefner launched Playboy magazine? It opened up a sexual revolution, and he was known for wearing pajamas and having a Playboy mansion, and you knew there was some crazy sex going on in there. Even well into his 90s, them Viagras, they really kept him going, but he's this old man with a cigar and these women. One of the women is talking. The A&E Playboy docuseries debuts in January. The woman, Holly Madison, dated Hugh Hefner from 2001 to 2008. Now, she wasn't the only one, because Hugh Hefner would have like 4 or 5 girlfriends at one time. Like I said, all had to compete. Like, who's the main girl? Well, he old as dirt. She says there was sexual assault in that mansion. She said there was drug abuse in that mansion. She said he was very verbally abusive. She was not allowed to wear red lipstick. One time, she cut her hair. He told her, "Why did you do that? Because you look old." Meanwhile, Hugh Hefner out here looking like a Crypt Keeper. That's going to be an interesting docuseries. Erykah Badu. Her 27-year-old boyfriend, she's showing off. Erykah Badu is 50. She cited, why is there such ageism when a woman dates a younger man and puts him out? I hear she's paying all his bills and everything. I think it's off-putting, because it's like, do we need to know this? She's showing him off, y'all. I hope this young boy don't hurt her. But she's showing him off. She wants the world to know that this young guy is her man. She is happy, and she's in love. Go Erykah Badu. Yolanda Adams is coming to BET in a new gospel drama, Kingdom Business. Devon Franklin, Kirk Franklin, they put this together. It's going to air on BET Plus, 8 episodes. Here's the premise. It's about the queen of gospel, who is Yolanda Adams. She keeps everything tight-knit. She's the first lady of the church. She's got a spectacular gospel career. But then she's got this rival over here, played by Soraya, the young woman from Empire. The young woman has a troubled past because she used to be a stripper, but she could always sing. And now she's decided to turn her life around and be a gospel singer. It's about family. It's about faith. It's about love. Ooh, I know Yolanda Adams is going to be good in this role. The series also stars actor Michael Jai White, actor Michael Beach. Tamar Braxton is in it. Go, Tamar. They're filming it right now in Atlanta, but it's coming on BET Plus next year. It was a lot today, but tomorrow we're going to have a lot to talk about. Now, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, give us a thumbs up if you like the video. It's not cute, not knowing. Let's keep Nick Cannon and his family and his child's mother, Alisa Scott. Let's keep them in prayer. Such tragic news today. Thanks so much for joining us. I appreciate you guys. I'm Patty Jackson. I am your auntie of pop culture.